Prima. मैडम, सुजाता मैडम, मैडम, हेलो मैडम, हेलो।
यस सर, एम ग्रेस स्टूडेंट।
मैडम, माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल?
यस सर, इट इज ऑडिबल।
ओके, व्हेन विल यू स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम मैडम?
इन सम टाइम सर, मैम विल अनाउंस इट सून।
ओके ओके ओके, थैंक यू थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू फॉर योर पेशेंस। थैंक यू।
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, shall we start now, sir?
Yes, madam. Okay, madam.
Yes, sir. Proceed, madam. Good evening to one and all present here on this fifth day and the last day of the 5 days national level faculty development program, a training series 1 held on 19th October to 23rd October 2020. Last 4 days of the 5 days national level faculty development program, a training series 1 had went on very well with our first special guest speaker on the first day, Dr. D. Venkatraman sir, who spoken on role of teacher in modern perspective with elaborative and pleasing manner. Second day, second special guest speaker, Dr. Shelby S. Madam, deliver her speech on traits of empowerment of self as extensively. Third day, our third special guest speaker, Dr. Radhika Vidyasagar, who has delivered a comprehensive speech on stint of emotional intelligence in academics. And yesterday, the fourth day, with our fourth special guest speaker, Dr. M. Kumarasamy, who has delivered as wide-ranging on creative teaching and learning process in dynamic institution. And also, the four of them have cleared and clarified the doubts and questions raised from the participant side at the end of their respective sessions. Participants are fully satisfied, hence the fourth day session have been completed successfully. On continuation of the fourth day session, today as a fifth day and last day of this 5 days national level faculty development program, 23rd October 2020 starts with our special guest speaker, Dr. C. Ranganathan sir, Associate Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, Bharathidasan University, Tiruchirappalli, is going to deliver his ample speech on innovative teaching and learning through ICT, e-learning, and special social media. To boot out from probing of knowing of today's special guest speaker, I call upon Mrs. Gris, my PhD scholar, to introduce and brief on his extensive academic travel till date. Over to Grace.
Good afternoon, one and all. Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, sir. This moment witnesses the delightfulness and the cherishable glory in welcoming and introducing Dr. C. Ranganathan, who has his MSc and MPhil in chemistry and MA in education and has his master's, MPhil and PhD in library and information sciences. He has, to his credit, UGC NET, CSIR NET, slit for lectureship in chemistry and in library science. He has 20 plus years of teaching experience, starting from 1999 as Scientist C in leave vacancy to an Associate Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, Bharathidasan University, now to a shining exposure in several teaching areas. Along with it, he has been a member of NARF 2016-19 at Bharathidasan University and has been a coordinator in School of Life Science Library, Bharathidasan University 2014-17. Till now, he has guided 31 PhD PG projects, 86 MPhil researchers, and is still guiding several young research minds. He has published in 150 plus national and international journals and conferences and has received several distinct awards for his papers. He has several exposure in efficiently organizing seminars, conferences, workshops, and events with grand success with flying colors. And he has participated in 100 plus conferences, seminars, workshops, and training programs to develop himself. He is a member of several professional bodies, editorial boards, advisory boards, and academic bodies. He has been a resource chairperson in 75 plus events. He is a reviewer for more than 10 international and national journals. He has experience in conducting 25 plus Viva for MPhil students. He has 25 plus research articles published in UGC journals. In brief, Dr. C. Ranganathan, sir, is an associate professor, Department of Library and Information Science, Bharathidasan University. He is a thirstful warrior, enlightening several students and keen to cobalt his colleague and teaching fraternity. Today, while I join you all in listening to Dr. C. Ranganathan, sir, I am so proud to introduce him and welcome him here, who is with us to light us in the topic Innovative Teaching and Learning through ICT, E-Learning and Social Media. Over to you, sir. Good day.
Good afternoon. The voice is audible?
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon to all. First of all, I would like to thanks to the organizing team members and especially from the Sujata madams given me opportunities today's session of the resource persons. So today we are going to talk about from the innovative teaching and learning through ICT, e-learning and social media. I saw from the lot of people, so senior most people are connecting from this FTP programs to attend that, attending here. So I am from very little bit knowledge I know to learn and sharing to all the faculty members and the scholars also. So now going to presenting from this my presentations. Full screen, huh? Emma? Undova? Right, share that, sir, visible? Hello, madam? Hello?
Sir, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
My yes, sir.
Visible? Yes, sir, visible.
Visible. Sir, good afternoon, Rob. So now going to presenting from my sessions to start. So innovative teaching and learning through ICT, e-learning and social media. No disturbance. So today, the young generations peoples are expecting.
Sharing to all the faculty members and scholars also.
Young generations people, we are expecting from the learning the concepts, the technology based of the aspects. So we are moved from the teacher as the faculty members, teaching fraternities. We are moved from these as per the technological aspects.
Hello, good afternoon, sir. Voice is not at all clear, sir.
Voice is not clear.
Voice is very feeble.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Now is clear my voice?
Now it's okay. Sujata madam, voice is very clear.
Okay.
Yes.
Somebody else are disturbance from this aspect, madam. My voice is clear or not?
Your voice is clear, sir.
My voice is audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Your voice is clear, sir. Clear. Yes, sir.
Okay. So today from the learning of the students, we are expecting from the concept from the technology based aspects. So in the olden days, knowledge is power. Today is a sharing of knowledge is powers. So the young generations, we are expecting from the visualized concepts. So you already know the senior most faculty members are there. The David Corner, you have to classify the knowledge. The seven type of the knowledge is classified. One is the aspects for the linguistic knowledge, and another one is for the musical knowledge, and another one is for the mathematical and the logical knowledge, and the fourth one is for the visual knowledge, and for the kinesthetics of the knowledge, or interpersonal or intrapersonal knowledge. But today, the every peoples or every students are expecting these from the visualization of the knowledge. Those visualized from the creativity of the visualized the expertise. So we are from the education persons, we say from the olden days, the 3R and the 3H. Majority of teaching faculty members are there, the education faculties are there. So the 3R and 3H, the reading, the writing, and arithmetics. And 3H means head, heart, hand. So two decades back, we are using everybody's from head, heart, hand. But the today young generations, everything's not short for the head, not for the heart, only from the using the mouse only is using. So as a teacher, the teaching fraternities, we can move the from the technological orientations. So when I was comments also, we are all from these, we are participants, the peoples are from the citizen of the India, but in the young generation from netizen of the Indias, the netizens of the peoples. So everything we have to learn to only from the ICT mode. So we know two teachers to change from teaching concept to be changed from a technological oriented. So before going to from these aspects, the informations and communications technology. So everybody's are knowing, I am not just explaining for the details. So that during the last decade of the 20th century, there was extraordinary development for ICTs. You see all things, information from the transmission of the process and the practices from the human activities, these aspects. So the technologies used in the conveying and manipulations and storage of data by electronic means. So if you want anything from the electronic means, if students are needed, students are expecting the aspects from everything to put it from the electronics via. Without electronics bias, we cannot accept this people's young generation of the peoples. So we need from the ICTs. So the information communication technologies continues that the data that has been stored and arranged, everything is systematically stored and arranged. For example, if you prepare the PPT, the everything systematic data is stored, is arranged, it's a sequence are there. So those organizing the facts and opinions, if any students are receiving during daily life. So changing the data into information is called data processing or information processing. As a teacher now from information processor, the data processor, we hope from the, all this information stored in particular places, we can receive the learn this concept to disseminate to the students. That is called from the data processing. And another aspect means, so gathering and organizing and reporting data to useful to deliver from the right time to the right persons, the right students, right scholars. It's often done using this information technologies. And another aspect means the two words we need to understand the communication technologies, the data and information. We know throughout the world, the plenty of data, plenty of information are there. For example, UNESCO has announced the 1970, 1 lakh millions of documents are there. 2000s, 1 crore millions. Now 100 crore millions of documents are there. So the data or information are available. Those data, this includes for the individual fact, each and every people to accepting some different of aspects. Some statistical data, some statistical ideas are created. These data, the facts, ideas, stored, arranged in the systematic manner to expecting from ICT mode. I think this present generation of the peoples. And you know that's ICT tools. So the 20 years back, we are the teachers for the Blackboard teachers. Present now also the Blackboard teachers. But some people are comments to me, sir, why you are using for the blackboards? So we have to store our mind. We can recover this everything's aspects. We can, the memory is created. But today, you see, everybody's not there. We then put it to the Google to put it the keyword, to show it this aspect, to deliver this message. So the ICT tools, the radio, the televisions, video, DVD, and telephones, and satellite systems, and the computer and hardware, softwares, and now we see everything for the video conferencing. We got everything by sharing for electronic mails. And another aspect for the black is created also. So we have from olden days, the 20 years back, Blackboard teachings are there. Then after we are going to the OHP sheets and phone pages are there. And we have the information for the wireless phones, communications or TVs or some other aspects. And another aspects for the LCD and PC, whiteboards, interactive panels. Now these every people are from the create the forums also. So we know the forums, we are connected for the search engines, some blacks, some e-groups. So throughout the world, around from the 8,000 search engines are there, but we are using from the Google only the search engines. You can only 7% of information to deliver, remaining from 93% of information start for deliver for the Googles. So we have to spread out a lot of search engines are there. But we are going to, for the Indian peoples are using the sharing automations, only the Google search engines. So we know the aspects from the every teaching methodology is going from the search engine based of informations, black based of informations, and e-groups of informations. And scope of internet as an ICT in educations. So ICT as a tool to innovative teaching learning practices via internets. So in the present days, the new education policy has recently has announced in the Indian government. So all things of these are e-learnings, are e-content, are digital contents. So multimedia way we teach the aspects. And for learning environment is a difference of aspects. For example, before COVID-19, after COVID-19, we are teaching everything from these online modes. As far as some of the meets, so the Google Meets, some of the forums, some of the aspects regarding sharing of information are there. Some of the social media are sharing of information. And some of the administrative tools are there in our education institutions, the education management systems. We developed this as far from the internet based of information to deliver from all the students. And for expanding learning opportunities for distance learnings. For example, you know the distance education programs are conducting per year for the 6 days or 10 days are conducting these programs also. Now for everything for learning for the distance learnings and e-learning also. For example, later I will explain from the e-learnings from these some of the MOOC and SWAM courses are there, the content that's created. So that is from the scope of internet as the ICT in educations. So next from, as a teacher, we know all the technological exposure of information are there, but what way how to communicate? The communication is simply is that, the transformation of information from one person to another person, and one person to two persons, one person to three persons, but every person are knowing that. But the exchanging of information from computer to another computer, how they are to connect the aspects. So for example, before start the classes, some people are says, some participants are says, our voice is not clear, but some exchange of information to one computer to another computer, some problems are there. And a classical communication system is made up on information source as an encoder, the transmitter, the receiver, the decoder, storage, the retrieval, and an information destinations. So that is very much important from this as a teacher, which information to communicate, which source to communicate, which encoder of the persons, which transmitter of the person, which receiver of the persons, which is very much important. That is known as from the communications. And we know that's from this. For example, you know for the formal communications, informal communications. So we are going to for the ICT, the synchronous communications are there. So the people are expecting these aspects. Already is the first, I have to inform these aspects from the seventh type of the knowledge, the visual communications. So the online chat, the text-based of informations, audio-based informations, the video-based informations, we are expecting from these young generation, the students' generations are there. And mobile technologies, if everything is sharing for the mobiles, the mobile conferencing, mobile sharing of information. So this mobile technology is going to be synchronous communications. And satellites, the television channels. We know for in our Tamil Nadu also, we are conducting from the television channels also. For example, e-Gynagas, the televisions are there. So that is for the all the education materials we deliver from each and every day. This is for the some of the communicated from the students. And the video conferencing, that is called for us synchronous communications. And as called as communications. So now we are expecting from this aspect for the discuss of forums. As a teacher, we are discussing about for some forums as a faculty members, the technology gatekeeper, or invisible college. These two things from the discuss about that, we can sharing to this another persons. And we can create for the blacks also. So each and every people shall create the website address. So we create the particular subject, particular topic, we are create for the blacks also. And the e-groups. And for the Wikipedia, everybody is knowing that's a Wikipedia. Wikipedia means what I know is. So what I know is from that is for knowledge-based informations. But my suggestions means Wikipedia is a first information, not best informations. And from the search engines. And mobile SMS and MMS and podcastings. These are all as common as communications. So now the necessity of the ICTs. So the necessity of ICTs means in our India, we are expecting, so throughout the world, it's expecting from globalization of the economics, the globalization of the informations. And those globalization of informations, globalization of economics, there's aspects from the technological innovations. We know the new education policy also says from the technology innovative teaching techniques aspects. And those technological innovations within the stipulated from the knowledge-based economy and the knowledge-based societies. And from based on from the demand, the escalating demand for education. So which person to the knowing, which persons to learn to given from these knowledge-based society, economics of experts, global information. Why this has been means the effective learning, the for all, any times, and anywhere places. So the ICT is a need from the any times, the anywhere, for all, to learning the concept from the knowledge based informations. So as a teacher, we moved from the ICT based teaching methodological aspects. And the scope of internet as ICTs, you know, everybody's are there, the scope from the educations are there, our research and communications, leisure entertainments are there, exploring the world, finance, shopping. But as a teacher, the educations, research, and the communications, and the exploring of the world. So what type of information is going on throughout the world? Now in India, which information is going on? For example, the UNESCO has the curriculum design, the all the continent. For example, throughout the world, 7 continents are there. In Asian continent, which type of information to deliver? We framed from the UNESCO. So we know need of these ICTs for the internet based for in Indian country peoples. The education, research, and communications, the exploring the world is very much important. And the use of the internet. This is for searching, we are using, people's are searching are there. The email service are given, the commercial service, the electronic books and publications, and the video conferencings, sharing data and results quickly, retrieving files and program of all types, find information databases and tutorials, newspaper columns, banking, downloadings, the newspapers, and the various educations, business governance, these aspects. So the world and days, if you want anything, the people's directly to went to particular organization to retrieve the information. But present days, all information is to avail from these databases. So a lot of open education resources are there, open databases there. If you want anything 24/7, we can retrieve all things of information. After retrieving, we can deliver to the school scholars and the students and that some other persons. And the traditional and the versus from the internet-based ICT educations. You know that the classrooms, the traditional classroom, ICT in educations. You know the physical limited size for these aspects, limited size for 40 students only. But for example, the Google Meets, the 250 students, 250 participants to one time to connected from the, all the people sharing of informations. The ICT in education for the unlimited. See anytime, see anywhere the places. For example, the school times, for the college times, for say 10-1 or 2-5. But we are going to for a content from 4-5, so for example, 6-7, we're conducting these aspects. And the content for the world and traditional classrooms for PowerPoints, transferences, textbooks, and the libraries, videos. But now the ICTs, we need this aspect education to students to deliver multimedia and digital libraries on demands. And already, as I say, from the synchronous, asynchronous communications expectations. And the personalizations means once learning the path, the traditional classroom means if any one person is to learning, this for single people's only. But the ICTs for their learning path and pace determined for the learners, but the different of the learners, we sharing the information. And the next one is from the psychology of using teaching aids, which include ICTs. So here is an effective sayings. So everybody, sir, as Vallabhar says from this, here is very effective sayings. I hear, I forget. But I hear only, but without any visualization, without store the minds. So the students to expecting from the visualized information to expectings. As from the teachers to convey to message from the ICT words, the verbal descriptions only are not enough for learners to remember to understand. They hear the aspects. The visualization of the objects, especially in science and technology, is important. So the visualized to seeing the peoples to immediately store the minds. The next aspect means I see, I remember. I see, I remember. Knowledge that is gained through the sight is more colorful, accurate, and permanent. It is said that 80% of the knowledge is gained through our eyes. So we need from the technological oriented visualized teaching methods to expecting from the present generation's peoples. And ICT can help learnings that develop understandings. The speed and automatic functions of ICT can enable the teachers to demonstrate, explore, or explain aspects of their teaching and students' learning more effectively. For example, use of spreadsheet to perform calculations in order to the patterns can be considered as the, rather than the calculatings. That is for the developing understanding from ICT, the peoples. The ICT can help learnings extend access to source. So for example, libraries for peoples. It's a world and days. The every source are occupied from these particular places. Now, this every source is available for the search engines, so databases, So difference of apps is that we can anywhere, anytime we can access to retrieve the documents. The capacities and range of ICT can enable teachers and students to gain access to historical or recent or immediate information through from internets. And enhance inquiry skills, the search for and compare information from different sources. So at a time, we can go into searching for the search engines, different types of search engines are open, the same information, different sources for the different of meanings, the same concept, a different of meanings, a different of views are given. That is from the main opportunities available from the ICT can help the learning the concept to deliver the students. And enhance the communications of ideas. So communicate with other peoples locally and over the internet. Hello. Hello. Present information in base, which are accessible in different forms for different audiences. So the ICT can from the present information, you know, from the every information are there in base, which are accessible in different forms of different audience to begin to attract it from these teaching technologies. And ICTs increase access to learning opportunities, the education opportunities in dispersed locations where conventional schools are not viable. So in the present situations, the education methods are for choice-based credit systems, CBCS. They charge students and parents of what they want to learn, choice-based credit systems after COVID-19. So all the students to expecting from choice-based credit systems are expecting. So these parents and students, what they want to learn, but not come to the school, not come to the college, not come to the university. Within the house, we have to learn some things. So please, the teaching methodology to be the change. So the expecting for the students. The safety net for school drops out. So they do not lapse into illiteracies. So alternatives venues to the aspect of colleges, second chance of the education, standardized the curriculum materials, the lifelong learning concepts to be developing from the ICT aspects. So and from limiting fraud in assessment process. For example, if you go to for the Google, the PPTs are, which is a copy or not, we are with the fraud of the assessment, the process to the everything's for showing from the ICTs. And for the goal and the key focus areas, the enhancing the reach, the quality of teaching and learning through ICT. The first from, we are for the education policy. The new education policies are says, everything's from the technology oriented teaching, the methodologies, teaching methodology to be adopted from the all the school levels to higher research levels also. And another aspect means a training of teachers. The next steps going to from this, the for learning, teaching and learning through ICTs. For example, when I was studied about from this, for the, not for the technological pupils, we know from the aspect from the reading and writing of methods of learnings, but now it's from the everything's aspect space for technological orientators. So the training of the teachers and the teaching and the learning concepts. So teaching methodology to be changed, learning concept are changed, and non-formal educations are there, and monitoring and measuring of the change. So everything's are changing, climatic changes. For example, BD and AC, some of the concepts are there. After COVID-19, after COVID, before COVID-19, post and free and these aspects, the monitoring, the measuring of change. And through the sharing of all the knowledge, the research informations to the end persons. That is the teaching and learning through the ICTs. And the potential of the ICTs. So the why this ICTs are need from the new education policy says, the potential of the ICTs, one is for the access. It's a very quick access, anywhere, any places of the access. And for efficiency, we have to learn some things. It's mind is free. We have to learn these concepts, the efficiencies to create. And from the learnings. And another one is from the teaching. As a teacher, we start teaching. We can access from the sources. Then access of the sources after the readings, after show each, the efficiencies to learn. The learning and the concepts, now we are going to the teach. And from skills formations. So we know the communicate to the people, students, where the skills formation is sharing and from lifelong learnings and for community linkages. So this for the community, the students' communities, our teaching communities, the linkage is given from the sharing to informations and from planning and management. So we think about the planning and management, how they are to ICT tools to deliver to the students and for the evolutions of the education technologies. So you know this time for the impacts. So the growing the aspect, T2, internet greatest impacts. You know, Web 2.3, Web 3.0, 4.0, 5.0 is coming now. So this is going on, this process is going on. For example, So this from the T2, this internet field. So that is for the evolution of the education technology. The national ICT agenda is means the people and the infrastructures, the applications and the contents. The peoples, the work cultures, the ICT skills. If you need from the ICT skills, for example, a lot of rural areas, there is no any ICT informations are there. You know, any connectivities are there. So we have to promote from these ICT skills as knowledge workers, the learning societies, united and moral and ethicals. And infrastructures are there, communications are there. The fiber optic cablings, for example, there is some of the rural area, there's no any cablings. We can promote this aspect. So gigabyte ATMs also, the satellites communications are there. Transport and the logistic of information are there. The infrastructures are available, national ICT agenda. And applications and content, smart schools, e-government, e-governance. So the Modi government has announced for e-governance, the smart cards methods, and the telemedicines, and the others also is there. So we know from this form, national ICT agenda, so people, infrastructures, and applications and content to interconnected to deliver to the knowledgeable society to develop. And the nation's ICT education visions. So the information societies, for example, 25, 30 years back, the information societies are there. 10 years back, apart from the knowledge societies. Now, the competitive societies. So this from ICT-based economics is need. Information society for the 2005, 2010 to from the knowledge society, 2020 from competitive societies. So we know from this, from the ICT need is very much in need. As a teacher, we deliver from the all communication from the ICT. So learning models will need to change. So the learning models, the industrial age, olden day from the industrial age, now the digital age, the learning models. How do people learn the digital environments? Is e-learning effective? But now he's expecting every people for e-learnings. So we are going to from the e-learning effectively. As a learners are ready, but the new learning models are needed. So what new models? Think creativity aspects. So the five important principles is very much important as a teachers. First of all, know yourselves, learn to relate, learn to communicate, empathy, think creativities. Not create for the sympathies, empathy, think creativities. As a learner ready, as a student, as a learner, as a ready, but a new learning model to our need are now is available are there. So teachers is going to from new model to deliver to the students. And the traditional and e-learning approaches. You know the classrooms are physical and synchronous. E-learning from anytime, anywhere are there. Already I have to explain from these traditional e-learning approaches also. And the deliver mode will change. So growth students populations. For example, 50 years back, the growth students populations. So now, if every people suffer, the more virtual universities are there, virtually without any walls, we can access. Now, without any walls, the one wire connection, without any connections, we are connected to the Google Meet, we can sharing of informations. So deliver mode will change. And the increase in the tuition fees also. So this for the school levels, the college levels, the traditional aspects, we know the increase in tuition fees, the cost-effective solutions, the e-learnings. So we teach from at a time to 250 students, the Google Meet. Zoom for the 500 students, we at times we can deliver the message. And the lack of facilities and the fundings and the privatization of the educations also, the deliver mode will change. The everything is by the budgets. These conducted from CR all online classes also. The privatization of the educations are delivered from these online modes. And the teaching aids already explains. And from the e-learnings. In an online, it's a multimedia learning environment. So now is for every people are learning from this, for the e-learning concepts. So teaching and learning is one-to-one, it's individual. So formal communications, the communications, one-to-one aspects. More interactivities, that's showing in normal classrooms. Learner or center, the learner monitoring or grading systems. That's for the e-learnings. What's the benefits of the e-learnings? For example, the UGC also, University Grant Commission has announced, if you create the e-contents, e-learning concepts. The MOOC SWAM programs are conducting also. The convenience, self-services, mix and match of the aspects. On demand of the aspects, if you any times, anywhere, any places, if you need the demand of the students, if you deliver these methods, give for the e-learning methods, and the private learnings, self-space, flexibilities. So we know the flexibility of information to deliver, it's a modular package. And benefits, cost-effectives, the virtual learning environments. share lessons among schools, reduce material costs, reduce the travels and the accommodators, and the benefits, consistency. This from the central control of contents, same quality of content for all, same quality of education for all. So without any partialities, the same quality content for all. So for example, the school levels also, the tuition is conducted. Conducting is there, conducted also, the teachers also. In classrooms, some subjects only stack in the classes. In going to the tuitions, the extraordinary classes to be taken. So there is no any these aspects, consistent, same quality of the content for all, same quality of education for all. And the media is rich, easier to understand, some more engaging, so repeatables. As many times as you like, this for the repeatable of the aspects. So to avoid the repeatable from these, the e-learning concepts. Easier to monitor progress, less administrative work can be more precise. So these are accurate information to deliver from these e-learning concepts. And teachers' obligations. The teachers' obligations means they use all available technologies. For teachers' obligations, all available technologies available from these availables. Encourage collaborative learnings. So now it's a blended learnings also there, the collaborative learnings. Lay foundation for lifelong learnings and incorporates the old and new aspects. So old and day, what type of information should share? The present situations, what type of information share? So we are the teachers to obligation from availability of the technological aspects. The availability of technological aspects to deliver to informations to the students. So building and e-learning cultures. So before building the e-learning cultures, so learner is important, and administrators and teachers. And the first aspect is the learners. So which type of the learners are there to deliver this aspect? For example, if you are going from the LKG students, how they are learn these concepts? So if you go from the TV, taking the classes for the LKG to the second standards. So we know from the need, self-directed, self-motivated, self-regulating, the lifelong learnings. And the learner is very much important. As a learner, which type of the learners? As a teacher, you have to develop the knowledge and skills. The update of knowledge we are expecting from the present scenario of the students. The update of the knowledge. Understand the learning and its needs. So they understand the learning and its needs. So the students are understand or not, some people are teaching the methodology. For example, the Google Meet, we teach the methods. Some people are understand or not, the hearing or seeing that whatever they said, I have to deliver the message also. The facilitate learns. So the facilities are available, we learn. They create learning opportunities. So next another aspect means to the learning opportunity to create for the students. And administrators create learning environment, provide ICT infrastructure, resources for lifelong learning. It's a building on e-learning cultures. E-learning is as a tools. So every teacher should have an email account. So communicate with the students, communicate with the parents also. Students can submit assignments, can have attachments, create paperless environments, simple but effective, efficient and cost effective. So present education system after COVID-19 is going on these concepts, e-learning tools. For each and every students are create email accounts. So all information is communicated to the students and parents also. So every assignments and seminars, whatever things also submitted from these mail IDs, the paperless environment is also going on for the e-learning tools. And the e-learning tool charts. So we know from the synchronous communication tools, already such explains, communicate with students and communicate with the parents. More students are participants, the collaborative learnings. So we know from the expecting for the students, the collaborative learnings. As a teacher, we know to create this aspect of the collaborative learning methodologies to create. And from these online forums, the asynchronous discuss forums, for example, e-forums, the blacks, whatever things are there. As a teacher, can create the discussion groups. If you create for this particular, for the classrooms, 40 students are there, 20 students are brilliant, 10 students are the average, and another 10 students for the poor. So we know they create from the discussion forums, discussion groups. Teachers could post their questions and request students to comment. Students can post their comments also, can encourage community participations, collaborative learnings can be fostered, feedback from diverse cultures. So these all informations to create for the teachers, the discuss groups, questions, post the questions and request the students to comment. Students can post their comments also, the community participators, and feedback from diverse culture. That is what we know of the feedback. So my teaching methods, how they are to learn. This everything is to learn from the feedback. And learning tools, web. A wide range of materials are available. So the tools are there, wide range of materials. For example, Wikipedia. If you go to the blue lines, it's got given. If you click from the all the information show it. That's from these wide range of materials are available. Teacher will need to narrow down. So those are the narrow information to take in to communicate the student from the technological aspects. It is a resource centers. For example, it's a library, it's a resource centers. So in this, for example, internet is one of the resource centers. Search engine is one of the resource centers. The database is a resource centers. Sharing of the resources, for example, in college levels, the UGC, InfoNets, for the Sojintu, all information to share from the all the scholars and faculty members. Sojintu recently, 2019, has announced from the present government, the Sojintu, older name from for the UGC InfoNets, Index, Genlist. These are all combined together, named the Sojintu. This for the sharing of resources, supported by images, audio, simulations, and multimedias. And e-learning tools. So a lot of video conferencing are there. Video technologies are there. For example, Byju's is conducted from a lot of video classes are going on. Can conduct the live lectures, communications with the students, communication with the parents, support by audio chat with the whiteboards, support sharing of applications. So a lot of applications are there. So you know that we showing this all these applications start for the students. If you're a teacher to showing these applications to read them, to sharing to the students, can be recorded and let it be used for demand lectures. Based on the demands, the demo to be delivered. That's for the e-learning tools, the video conferencing. And tools, learning management system, LMS. For example, everything for all institutions, all universities, colleges also, for the olden days, it's a library store from these, the documents, the documentations work is going on. Now, the all this information for the LMS, learning management system. It's a management of the content, tracking of students. For example, if your PPT is stored from this in your organizations to create from the LMS, to any times tracking the students, the administrative features, integrations with the various tools such as chat, forums, emails also, the reportings, demo of the multimedia learning system also. So all video or audios or everything or PPTs, whatever things to create from this LMS, this for the open source softwares, if we create from the all this information stored, so it's any times of tracking the students to any times if you doubts, you can show it this aspect to learning these concepts. This from the learning management system. Some of the software, learning management software systems are there. So Moodle, one of the, not for the Noodle, it's a Moodle. Moodle is one of the easier learning platform designed to provide educators, administrators, and learners with a single, robust, secure, and integrated system to create personalized learning environment. This is for the open source software. This, all these PPTs are videos and lectures, everything is stored from the softwares. And Edumi is in the mobile-based training platform that gives your workforce knowledge they need to succeed. For example, recently, yesterday, I saw from the newspaper, Hindu newspaper, the Anna University Library to start from this for mobiles. If you want anything from, if you create for the user I login, if you want anything to learn from within 24 into 7 to create from the MyFlat, this one they create from the Anna University Library also. So the Udemy and the Magic Box Learnings. That's for the, this is for the one of the from learning management subsystem. And for the Dursair, it's an online tool from the interflow of the Dallas user to manage documents. So all these aspects is available for the learning management systems. Next aspects means the social medias. The social sendings, for now, the every people start for sharing of information, social medias. Without social medias, we cannot deliver. So every people, for example, we all shared information from the social medias. The social selling is in making a few tricks to your daily routine to align yourselves with the new bias behavior. These tricks will be like putting high octane fuel in your race car. That is for the social selling. The social proximities, where the people are the social proximities, refers to how close your social connections or to that of your prospective customer, prospective students, prospective scholars, and social medias, you are always growing your network of the social connections. So more mutual connections, higher social proximities, and higher likelihood for getting the good and quick interactions to the referrals. This for the social proximities very much important before sharing the social medias. And search engines. So now the search engines very dominate, already explained. The recent research suggested that social sharing has now become the number of one drive from SEO rank. Search engines, right? In other words, Google and Bing are monitoring the social sharing activity for each sites and are assigned substantial weight on that activity to determine the search rank. That's for the information is given by the social media, the search engine influence. So what is a social media? Social media refers to online tools and services which allow an exchange of ideas, informations, videos, pictures, and graphics, just about anything you can name. The social medias also allows easy sharing and the distribution of existing content to others so that professionals' work can be shared through networks. So that is from social medias. So the social medias, these for key social potentials. So from the blogging, you create for the blog. We can connect it from this all information to share and micro blogging and RSSs. RSS mean rich site summaries and widgets, social networking and chat rooms, message boards, podcasts, and video sharings and photo. So these are all from these social medias with the connect for the web 2.0. Now it's going for web 3.0 also. These are all lot of social medias are there. We can sharing to the information from the all these aspects. So what is web 2.0? The websites are internet applications which empower people to share information, work together. So these were web 2.0, the share of information from the empower of the peoples to work together. And the usability and accessibility are key to Web 2.0. So what would we type of the social media services? So bookmarking sites and social news sites. So this is for the DIC, this is for the bookmarking. If you want for any people, any teachers or faculty members, scholars, the DIC. The blacks is micro blacks, Twitter and the temples. The social networking sites are there. Everybody's knowing Facebook and Google Plus, not for Google, Google Plus. The shopping sites for Amazon. Before the starting the Amazon for the book selling, sir, book publishing only. So the from the now is for the all these aspects and the multimedia sharings, YouTube, Flickr, the virtual worlds, World of Warcraft, and the Second Lives. So these are all from the social medias. You know, from everybody's social Flickr, Dick, Facebook, YouTube, MySpace, and Francis Meetup. These are all things from the social medias. And so, what are the real benefits of the social medias? It's going to teach. The organization's message will reach the wider audience. So the old organizations or college or universities or schools or expecting firms that will reach for the wider audience of the peoples. The strengthens of the builds the relationships. So we are more connected from the real benefit from the social media to the peoples, engages the constitutions. The facilitates the collaborations, mobilizes constitutions around issues that are important to them and creates advocates. Easier and a broader dissemination of the information. So these all these from the real benefits of the social medias. And dues of the social medias, so provides value, be genuine, strategize, and listen, be creatives. So that is called from the social media we get sharing the teachers. For example, the Facebooks. The Facebooks allows you to directly engage with constitutions with a variety of different medias, such as videos, polls, and status updates. So the dissemination information, what is a NAP? So NAP is to ensure the political, the educational, and the societal, the economical equalities are higher for all persons to eliminate access from the access to the discriminations. So that is for the what is the NAP are doing on. Get feedback, the comments and likes quizzes, launches cases and donations drives, financial freedoms and center Facebook pages. And as for the Twitter, you know, there's some of the social media Twitters. Twitters connect you with the constitution through the exchange, quick, frequent answers. The one simple questions, what are you? instantly connected with the peoples who are interested in similar issues, interact with the constitutions, disseminates information to wider audience, Financial Freedom Center tweeters. So we need for the tweet also. We can from the publications also, from the tweets, from the connector, from the gating of the citations also. And the link to top by best practices. Think for the search engines optimizations, be active, follow industry influences, and admit to chart. Don't talk about your news source. And tips for all platforms. You have a consistent brand, engage. If it is posted, it is a public. You cannot, as a little self-promotion goes a long way, but brackets are equal, if not more anyway, online than they are in persons. You don't have to everywhere. Connect virtuals, want locally, this with the Twitter tips for the platforms. So thank you. Any clarifications? My presentation is over.
Thank you, sir. Can you hear me? Thank you. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you. Your words were so engrossing and your gripping knowledge was unputdownable. Once again, thank you, sir. And I hand over the session to Dr. Sujata, ma'am. Ma'am, I hand over the session to you.
Yes, sir. Dear participants, do you have any doubts or clarification with our speaker? You can have a discussion. You can raise your doubts also if he is here to clarify you all. If any doubts or any clarifications needed.
Sir, this is Dhanlakshmi, sir. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Dhanlakshmi, sir, is raised. You can ask, ma'am.
Sir, my friend is a blind, sir.
Okay.
Actually, her memory power is so good, excellent. And I'm mostly, I have seen many blind people there. Their memory power will be really excellent, actually. While you're presenting, you were just mentioning that, you know, like, while hearing, you will just... it will be retained, you know, like whatever we are teaching, if you have, the student is going to hear, it will be retained for, you know, like to the lesser extent compared to that of, you know, watching the thing, like whatever we are presenting. But, you know, like, I just have a doubt in this. Can you just clarify with this, sir?
Tell me,
my question is clear.
Hello.
Am I making it clear, sir?
Yes.
Sir? Shall I type it or?
Please type it.
Sir, my doubt is, sir, am I audible?
Audible. Yes.
Sir, actually, வந்து பார்வை தெரியாதவங்களுக்கு வந்து நிறைய மெமரி பவர் அதிகமா இருக்கு எனக்கு தெரிஞ்ச வரைக்கும் என்னோட பிளைண்ட் சரி மேடம் எல்லாமே இப்ப பாத்தீங்கன்னா நீங்க ஆக்சுவலா நீங்க பிரசன்ட் பண்ணதுல கேக்குறத விட பாக்குறது பெட்டர் ஆக்சுவலி 80% ரிட்டென்ஷன் will be there. That's what you mentioned.
Yes.
Actually, how is it, you know, like, but you know, like, when they are able, எனக்கு தெரிஞ்ச வரைக்கும் blind friends எல்லாம் வந்து நல்ல ரிட்டென்ஷன் அதிகமாவே இருக்கு.
If you understand, ma'am, blind is for the God grace to give these from the knowledge power.
Okay.
But UNESCO has announced.
Okay.
So the visualized learning concepts is very much important. So to 80% of the persons to visualize to learnings to memory the store. But I am not announced. So UNESCO, International Education Scientific Council Organization, has announced from. So 80%. We are framed for the curriculum.
Okay.
So throughout the world, the curriculum is designed.
Okay.
So UNESCO is first, but I am not science. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.
Any other clarifications needed from participant side? Okay, I think it's all clear from participant side. We can go ahead. dear all, the two hardest things to say in life are hello for the first time and goodbye for the last. With this Moira Rogers quotes, I'm start with saying word of thanks. At last, we came at the end of this last day of this 5 days national level faculty development program, a training series one, to give note of thanks. The best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such prayer among them. I'm Dr. P. Sujata, here to spell out words thanks to all those who made this evening a sweet memory to carry home. I consider it a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this exceptionally important event. My words is not enough to express my gratitude on behalf of college. And now I would like to thank our 5 days special guest speakers, Dr. D. Venkatraman sir, Dr. Mrs. Shelvi S. madam, Dr. Radhika Vidyasagar madam, Dr. M. Kumarasamy sir, and today's special guest speaker, Dr. C. Ranganathan sir, who all, despite the busy schedule, have found time to grace this occasion. I like to thank our honorable principal, Dr. D. Gladys, Bardi Women's College, to given me this very good opportunity to conduct this event. And also, I thank to our head of the department and our department staff members and other department staff members of our college for their backbone support. I thank all the distinguished invitees who have given their presence for this auspicious day by accepting my invitation. Last but not least, like a pillars of the buildings, how important it is. Of course, the same way, without any participants and the registrations on this event, by giving their presence physically and mentally for this auspicious occasion, it won't be completed successfully. Hence, my great and gratitude to all the registered participants. Thank you all participants. Also, I show appreciation to the people who have been strength of this event. Once again, I would like to state that I am glad to all speakers here over this auspicious day event. I thank you for being with us. It has remained a pronounced pleasure. I would like to give a special thank and honor to Dr. D. Venkatraman sir, who helped me to catching our extraordinary special guest speakers for this special auspicious occasion to conduct through a great success. So I spread my most sincere thanks to the Lord God for giving me such a kindful person. Thank you, Venkatraman sir. You all make the world come alive. You all make the world colorful. You are the inspiration behind all that happened. You all are the pillars of strength to many around you. An individual has not started and living until he rises above the confines of his individualistic concerns to the broader concern of all humanity. With these words, I wish you all happy, wonderful day ahead. Thank you so much. Thank you all.
Thank you all participants. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you a lot.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Very excellent program.
Ma'am, feedback on the work of Matanda, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Let me check, sir. It will work. Let me know. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you so much.
And ma'am, feedback work out.
I will rectify it, son. Don't worry. You will keep going. You keep going on your link, feedback link. It will definitely I will make it rectified. Don't worry. Don't bother. And one more announcement. Solling, sir.
இப்போ ஃபீட்பேக் கொடுத்துட்டு அதை இது பண்ணுவேன்னா பேக் பட்டன் கொடுத்துட்டு இது பண்ணுங்க இல்ல ப்ரீவியஸ் போயிட்டு அதை கேளுங்க அப்படின்ற மாதிரி கேக்குது அதனாலதான் ஒரு டவுட் இருந்துச்சு
okay in in the session close panite na and adra open panni paatha I can tell you what is the problem is or what the solutions can given you
okay, ma'am. No ma'am I given to my email address ma'am then
let me clarify it. Actually this is not a much problem. You can clarify even minutes, okay? Be online, otherwise I am not closing anyhow. I don't close end. I'm not ending this session also till your feedback you get there. Okay. One more announcement is there. Those people who have attended all 5 days also will get a course completion certificate according to that basis on the everyday certificate, that is automatic generation certificate will be receiving you all. That is those who have attended 5 days.
Ma'am, I am attend the first day class, but I am not fill the feedback, ma'am. I am forget, ma'am.
No, that will be there. Registered means once you enter into our meet means definitely you all are eligible for that. No need to bother and all.
Yes, ma'am.
That daily attendance like that. But I am not
third day மட்டும் work அது நான் attend பண்ண அது எனக்கு மறந்து போச்சு மேடம் அதனால தான் third day மட்டும் attend பண்ணல but the first second fourth fifth full attend
பண்ணி yes I agree but I am not settled it actually it is automatic generation for 5 days who have attended 5 days they will get it automatically for a course completion otherwise also you are getting each certificates for each day that is
yes
that is that will be receiving for 5 certificates for each day there's no doubt at all you will
get it.
No problem.
Yes, ma'am.
For course completion, yeah. The people who are eligible for 5 days get in inside. Okay.
Yes. Ma'am, na ipo vandu na Sridevi college la work pandra. Edachi doubt anda unga anda certificate la ungala na contact pannalama ma'am.
Sure. Enoda mail ID la neenga adla contact pannikalam. Otherwise also idu group clear. Okay, sir.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
हेलो हेलो मैडम हेलो 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 मैडम हेलो हेलो हेलो
यस सर
हाँ मैडम फीडबैक इज नॉट वर्किंग
प्लीज वेट सर सून विल बी दैट विल बी रेक्टिफाइड The same would the same link would work. Just wait for a while; it would be rectified.
First time I filled all feedback link details and then submit, but it is not submitted. Okay,
sir. Please do wait. We'll check and just rectify it.
Okay.